Hi, I'm Drew Claiborne. On today's tool tip, I'd like to show you how to enter the settings menu of a Digimatic multiplexer. We'll begin by plugging in the supplied USB cable and power cable. First, I'll plug in the USB cable. Second, I'll plug in the power cable. And then we'll go to the software. To begin, I'm going to load the Windows Device Manager to make sure that I can see that the unit is plugged in. Notice I do have a Mitutoyo Virtual COM port / human interface device where the drivers have not yet been loaded. This is what I expect to see. If I do not see this on the list, then I need to make sure that my USB connection is secure and that I am receiving power to the unit. Since I can see the device in my Device Manager, I need to update the drivers that came with the multiplexer. For this example, I've already copied the drivers from the CD-ROM and they're located on my desktop under a folder called MIG USB Drivers. As I return to the Device Manager, I'm going to right-click on the device called Mitutoyo VCP/HID device, and I'm going to select Update Driver. I'm going to now select Browse My Computer for Driver Software, and I'm going to browse out to the folder that I just showed you on my desktop. And select OK. I have include subfolders checked. I'm going to now select Next. If you're prompted by Windows Security, you can select Install. Once complete, I will get a confirmation screen that the drivers have been successfully installed and that my MIG box is now on COM port 6. Hit Close to end this process, and now we can see that the device is still in my Device Manager, but the icon next to it has changed because Windows now successfully has recognized the multiplexer box. Once this step is complete, we can now close the Device Manager. The CD included with the multiplexer has a terminal program that we will use to communicate with the multiplexer. If you already have a terminal program that you wish to use, that's fine as long as you can access any serial port on the computer. I'm going to begin by loading TerraTerm. Once TerraTerm is open, the default connection is for a TCP/IP communication setting. I'm going to switch that to serial, and you notice this already defaults for a COM6 Mitutoyo device. If your unit does not default to this, you can select a down arrow and then select the Mitutoyo VCP/HID device from your drop-down list. Now I will click OK. For my convenience, I'm going to maximize the TerraTerm window. From here, I'm now going to go to the Setup menu and select Serial Port. We already know that the multiplexer is on COM port 6, but how do I know what the speed, data, and parity settings are? Well, we can actually pull that off of the unit itself. As I turn the multiplexer over, there's a sticker on the bottom where I can see what the output is. We'll start with RS-232. Remember when we loaded our drivers, our computer was set to COM port 6. Our bottom parity settings are 9600N8. I want to make sure that these settings correlate with the settings that are in my terminal program. So we can see here that my COM port is still set to COM 6. The speed, data, parity stop bits, all of this matches the sticker I found on the bottom of the multiplexer unit. Select OK to confirm these settings. Once my settings are confirmed, I'm back at the main screen of the terminal program. From here, I type in SPC in all caps. And now I've entered the setup menu for the multiplexer. Once the main menu is loaded, I can see that it's divided into two sections. The top section will show me each individual port for the multiplexer. Since I'm using a four-port box here, I have four different ports that are showing up in the software, and it shows me how they're individually configured. The bottom section of the main menu allows me to go in and make specific changes so that the box performs the way I expect it to. To save any changes that you make to the main menu, type EX followed by the Enter key to exit and save the changes to the multiplexer. To exit without saving any changes, type QU followed by the Enter key to exit the multiplexer and not save any changes that were just made. Thank you for taking the time to watch today's tool tip. If you have suggestions for future videos, please leave those in the comments below. Or if you have any questions, please feel free to give us a call at 888-MITSUTOYO or visit us online at www.mitsutoyo.com.